The calm before the storm. We got here, front row seats. Beat the crowd at the top of the world. And not in but an hour, Christine and Mike will be married up here and we'll all be celebrating their love and our family. It's a beautiful day out here in Sutton's Bay.
Start. Let's do this.
You dad?
Come over here. You'll be on the other side of Mike.
Don't wanna be a peer, 'cause everyone comes to look. Don't wanna be anything but my life's an open book.
Did that eye out thing beautifully? Let's close it in a little bit.
Staring at the fire for hours and hours while I listen to you play your love songs all night long.
And my name is Rob Ford. Christine and Mike have invited us all out here to bring us to the top of the world. We're as close to the sun as we're going to get, I think. And anyway, we're going to do a little civil ceremony this afternoon. And to start off, Christine has asked me to read a poem by a woman named Mary Oliver. And I don't know if you're familiar with Mary. She was a Pulitzer Prize winning poet, and she and her partner lived out in Provincetown, which is at the tip of the Cape Cod thing in Massachusetts. So they're right on the water. My point is, they're right on the water too, and this is a poem that written about Provincetown, but it works for this. Coming Home. It's called Coming Home by Mary Oliver. When we're driving in the dark on the long road to Provincetown, when we're weary, when the buildings and the scrub pines lose their familiar look, I imagine us rising from the speeding car. I imagine us seeing everything from another place, the top of one of the pale dunes or one of the deep and nameless fields of the sea. And what we see is a world that cannot cherish us, but which we cherish. And what we see is our life moving like that, along the dark edges of everything, headlights sweeping the blackness, believing in a thousand fragile and unprovable things, looking out for sorrow, slowing down for happiness, making all the right turns, right down to the thumping barriers to the sea. The swirling waves, the narrow streets, the houses, the past, the future, the doorway that belongs to you and to me. It's a nice poem. So, we have some vows. Let's do your vows.
I'll go first. Time.
I promise to find gratitude in the moments of bliss and the moments of difficulty. I promise to be your teammate and not your competitor. I promise to continue working towards spiritual, mental, and physical wellness so I can support and nourish our marriage. I promise to treat you with kindness, listening without judgment, while always practicing grace and humility. I promise to keep our time sacred, to go on dates, to be fully present, and to save time to waste with you. I promise to keep our home sacred, to pull the weeds, to play good music, to keep our doors open. I promise to keep our family sacred, to gather around the table, to laugh and play games, and to grow together. I promise to remember that love is a verb and to speak with actions as well as words. I promise to take a deep breath, take a dip in the lake, and always take on the next adventure with you.
I promise. I tried memorizing. I promise to find gratitude in the moments of bliss and the moments of difficulty. I promise to be your teammate and not your competitor. I promise to continue working towards spiritual, mental, and physical wellness so that I can nourish our marriage. I promise to treat you with kindness, listening without judgment, while always practicing grace and humility. I promise to keep our time sacred, to go on dates, to be fully present, and to save some time to waste with you. I promise to keep our home sacred, to pull the weeds, to play good music, to keep our doors open. I promise to keep our family sacred, to gather around the table, to laugh and play games, to grow together. I promise to remember that love is a verb and to speak with actions as well as words. I promise to take a deep breath, take a dip in the lake, and take on the next adventure with you.
Nice. Wedding rings. Billy, you get the wedding rings.
I do.
Nice. Michael, you can put that on Christine's finger. Christine, do you take Michael as your wedded husband to heaven to hold from this day forward, richer for poor, in sickness and health, for better for worse, as long as you may live?
I do.
And Michael, do you take Christine to be your wedded wife to heaven to hold from this day forward for the rest of your life, richer for poor, sickness and health, for better for worse? May you part?
I do.
It's customary for the officiant to say a few words at a wedding, and I always leave it in the hands of another poet, not Mary Oliver, but the American poet Ogden Nash, who had some great advice for all of us, whether you've been married for just a couple of seconds or whether it's been 40, 50 years, whatever, or even if you're not married. He said to keep your marriage brimming with love in the wedding cup. Whenever you're wrong, admit it. Whenever you're right, shut up. By the powers vested in me, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Oh. Yeah.
I just want to say a few words and thank everybody for being here. And I thought a lot about what to say here for this toast. And I think that, you know, a lot of our initial attraction, Christine and I, was because opposites attract. And we're very different people in a lot of ways. But I think that what's going to keep us together is the things that we have in common. And the number one thing we have in common is the importance of family. And we both just have amazing families and parents and siblings and aunts and uncles. You know, they say you can't choose your family, but you can. We choose our families every day. And we choose our friends who we also consider family. So thank you for being here, and here's to let's keep choosing each other. That's it. Speaking of family, so John and Patrick are going to sing a song for us. We're going to have a kind of an impromptu first dance. And you know, I don't know how it's going to go, but, you know, feel free to join us. And, yeah. Yep.
Well, I knew Bugsy and I would get along well when we started going to concerts together, including the son of Frank Zappa. I think that was when your sister's boyfriend asks if you want to go to a Zappa concert together, you just know you're going to be brothers and best friends forever. This one goes out to you guys.
I won't let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. For once I have something I know won't desert me. I'm not alone anymore. For once I can say, this is mine, you can't take it. As long as I know I have love, I can make it. For once in my life, I have someone who needs me.
let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. For once I have something I know won't desert me. I'm not alone anymore. For once I can say, this is mine, you can't take it. Long as I know I have love, I can make it. For once in my life, I have someone who needs me. Someone who needs me.
Someone who needs me.
Someone who needs me.
Somebody who needs me.
For once in my life, I won't let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. For once I have something I know won't desert me. I'm not alone anymore. For once I can say, this is mine, you can't take it. Long as I know I have love, I can make it. For once in my
time to party. For the first time, as Christine and Mike are in the Subaru. Congratulations.
The Marital Vehicle.
We'll see you there. Drive off into the sunset.